I went to, on Monday, I went to something at the Council of Churches and said, I believe there were at least 12 to 13 murders in the city of Springfield since the new year. That's every 2 weeks. So that all of us who got paid this year, there was someone killed every time we got paid. That's horrific. There's children that are committing suicide. There's bullies in our schools, there's internet predators, there's TV shows that show us a different way of living that's different from the way that the Bible wants us to live. There's news and there's reports and there's crime and there's mayhem and there's, no matter what station, it could be 5, it could be channel 40, it could be 22, it could be channel 3 if you don't have cable. Any station you turn into, there's bad news. It's a dark and dreary space. I'm not trying to make anyone sad, but I don't want them to understand the reality of how dark the world that we live in. And so it's dark and dreary. There's lavish living. There's antics all over the place. If anyone, how many people here have Facebook? Y'all look real scared.
Is speaking.
It's not President Obama, it's not the Republicans, it's not the Democrats, it's not the governor, these are powerful people. This is Jesus, our Jesus, that we live, that we love, and that we worship. It's our Jesus, the great I am, the great emancipator. It's our Jesus who put the sun and the moon and the stars together. It's our Jesus that's remained in his image. It's our Jesus. Who's able to keep the sand here and not allow the ocean to run over to the sea. It's our Jesus that allows the birds to fly and the falcons and still take care of the little itty bitty ants. Our Jesus. I want you to understand how large he is. And how great he is. You know, I want you to know he's bigger than one of those, what is it, the Beijing planes that they call about 200 people. He's bigger than that. He's bigger than the Texas, the biggest state that we have. He's bigger than anything that we can imagine. That's who's speaking. He's talking to his disciples. And he's given the most famous sermon that's out there. This will fail in comparison to what Jesus did on the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus is talking to his disciples. And he's teaching them about some biblical truths that they needed to know. He may have spent some time with them, but this is one of the reported longest sermons that in history. He is the master teacher. Imagine being able to sit. I know we say a lot of songs about he is the master's feet, but they were at the master's feet. And in those days, when they were teaching, they would sit out. They didn't stand as he formally preached and stand in our pulpits and stuff. But as he taught them and their customs, they would sit and be relaxed. I don't know if they're going to be here 3-4 days. I don't know if they packed their lunch. You would not be here that long. somebody just said hallelujah. I heard it. So Jesus is sitting down and he's sharing with them this most impactful sermon. The sermon on the Bible. And he's teaching about different areas and ways that we can deal with the darkness. He teaches about practical living. He teaches about the law. He teaches about anger. He's teaching about being blessed as he starts off with bless all the Beatitudes. Amen. He teaches about the salt and the salt loses its savor. I think that's verse 13 if I'm correct. If I'm not correct, me. And eventually he gets to three little verses about the life. So let's talk a little bit about the life. The Bible uses several attributes about the life and pertaining to our Lord. In John 1:4-5 says, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend. But also in John 8:12, John 8, it says, then Jesus spoke to them saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of God. I said it one time, Jesus spoke to them. And I already told you who Jesus was. So when he says stuff, he's bigger than he ever. When you talk, when he talks, people listen. I am the light of the world. And he who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. The light is God. And those who are in the right standing with God, those who are light bearers, those who are in covenant relationship with him, will take on the attributes of the light. Does that make sense? But what are some of the attributes of light? Well,